Hello everyone, welcome to the Unistellar channel. Thanks for being here. This is the second video about the Unistellar app. In the first video, we talked about how to get the best image quality possible by using the observation settings in the eVscope tab. Today, we're going to talk about all the options you have to find all the objects in the sky. The app gives you very efficient ways to narrow your research to find the perfect object in no time. Ready? Let's go. All right, let's go back and have a walk through the Unistellar app, and we'll stop by the Explore tab because it's here that you'll be able to find all the objects you're looking for. The Explore tab is the second tab of the Unistellar app. You don't have to connect your smartphone to the eVscope to open this tab, but you do have to connect your smartphone if you want to use the go-to feature. You should know what the go-to feature is. If not, refer to our first video, how to set up your eVscope. So, what exactly is the Explore tab? Well, it's kind of a huge library with over 5,500 sky objects to search for and counting. That's quite a lot. That's why it's really interesting to know all the options available that will allow you to find all the objects you're looking for in just a few seconds. Here's what it looks like. First, you can see that you have a search bar on the top of the screen. This is extremely useful when you want to find an object very quickly. If you know the name of the object, just type it in and the app will give it to you. You can also type in its messier name, like for instance, M42 for the Orion Nebula, M27 for the Dumbbell Nebula, or M51 for the Whirlpool Galaxy. The only thing is, you have to know the object's name, but you could also simply type in galaxy, nebula, or cluster, and the app will show you a list of the object you can see right now based on the word you just typed. Touch the little cross to erase your research. Don't hesitate to use this search bar. It's really useful, and it's usually the fastest way to find an object. Below the search bar, this is where you'll have all the objects sorted by type. You'll find a list of objects recommended by Unistellar. I definitely recommend you start with this category. This is really nice because you don't have to search through all the categories below to find something really interesting. Unistellar does it for you. In this list, you'll find the most interesting and great looking objects that you can see right now. First, you'll find objects that are really close to where your eVscope is pointing at. It will find them in a few seconds. And then, as you swipe to the left, the objects will be located further and further away from where your eVscope is pointed. If, for instance, you pick the last object, your eVscope will have to move from one point in the sky to the other. Then you have two categories, appearing soon and fading soon. Appearing soon, as its name suggests, will show you objects that will be showing soon. It's a good way to plan your observations and to check what could be the next object to look for. On the other side, fading soon will show you objects that will soon disappear, either behind the horizon or behind a wall that would block your field of view. We'll talk about it in a minute. So be sure to check this list once or twice during your observation. You don't want to miss a wonderful galaxy or a beautiful nebula. Then you'll find all the sky objects listed by categories. You have galaxies, nebulae, star clusters, stars, planets, asteroids, and transit events. And finally, the advanced section, where you can manually enter coordinates like the right ascension and declination, or the altitude and azimuth. This is really useful when you want to locate a comet that hasn't been registered on our database yet. When you select an object, it will open an ID card. You'll find useful information like its location and coordinates, how long you will be able to see it. You'll also have a nice graphic that will show you the object in its constellation. This is really nice because it allows you to locate the object with the naked eye. For the most popular objects, you'll find some great information if you scroll down a little bit. Be sure to read the text. You'll learn everything you need to know about its size, distance, age, and composition. Our team is working every day to add new descriptions. This is really great if you want to animate a demonstration in public. You'll always find good information to share with other stargazers. All right, now that we've seen all the categories you can use to find an object, let's go deeper into the settings by clicking on the icon in the top right corner. This will open the sky window settings. Here, you'll find some options that will act like filters. When you modify them, it will display either more or less objects. First, you'll see information about the date and the location. Then, the first option that you can play with is visibility. Depending on whether you are observing the sky in town, in the suburb, in the countryside, the light pollution can prevent you from seeing the faintest objects. That's why it's better to select the right visibility so you don't have too many objects or not enough, but only the objects that you can actually see. Keep in mind that if you don't find a particular object or planet in the list while you're in a place where you should be able to see it, it may be that the visibility is set to city or suburb. Just select countryside and the app will show you many more objects. And there you go for visibility. Then you have altitude and azimuth. When you connect your eVscope to your smartphone, the app will automatically show you its altitude and azimuth coordinates. Then you can move the yellow points to change the angle that your eVscope can see. Let's say that you live in a flat and you observe from a balcony and you have trees or a wall, basically anything that would prevent you from seeing the whole sky. The altitude setting allows you to select a range. If you can't have access to the sky above 80 degrees, for instance, or below 20 degrees, you can move the two yellow dots at the right angles. The app will show you only the objects that are located in this area and will hide those who are too high or too low in the sky. The azimuth works exactly the same way. If, for instance, you can see from the northwest to northeast, then move the two yellow dots to the right position. It'll act as a filter to show you only what you can see. Now you can go back to the list to choose among the objects that you can see. And if you want to reset everything and go back to the original settings, you can touch the reset button just below the azimuth settings. And there you go. Now you know how to use the settings to display your favorite objects. Don't hesitate to use them. It'll help a lot during your observation sessions. We really hope you liked this new video. Be sure to click on the thumbs up, leave us a comment, and tell us what you think about your eVscope. Stay tuned for more videos and clear skies with Unistellar. See ya!